गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. ओके, सो इट इज वन ऑफ द गुड चैप्टर, वन ऑफ द गुड चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 12, एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन एंड इज द पार्ट ऑफ ए कैलकुलस. नाउ स्टार्ट्स डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. ओके, बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट्स दिस इक्वेशन, डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, वी विल मेक मी क्लियर वन थिंग अबाउट व्हाट इज इक्वेशन. देर आर इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस यू हैव लर्न मेनी इक्वेशंस like linear, quadratic equations, cubic equations, biquadratic equation. There are several equations you have already learned. But what is differential equation? That is most important things here. Now, linear equation. So can you give one example of linear equation that is involving variable as well as constant, that is x plus 2 equals to 0. So it is a linear equation and it is a linear equation of one variable. It is a linear equation of one variable. Now comes to the equation of linear equation of two variable. Linear equation of two variable, that is x plus y minus 2 equals to 0. Students, why it is called one variable and linear equation? Because the algebraic expression involving here, that is one, here one variable used, here two variable used, here two variable, and is here only one variable. If you think about its power, now what will be the power? 1. That's why it called as linear. But our topic is different, that is known differential equation for your class 12 concern. But the question is, why we are clear about your linear equation? What is the relations of this equation to the differential equation? Every equation in the world is same. There are two quantity, and do the two same quantity both the sides, that is in the left hand side as well as in the right hand side. Whatever the quantity contained in the left hand side, that will be equivalent to the same quantity contained in the right hand side. That is the concept of equation in the every equation. Linear, why it is called linear? Because the degree of equation only one, the highest power of variables, the variables are x, y here, and the degree is 1. That's why it is called linear equation in one variable. But the involvement of variables here must be. So that's why it is called a linear equation. So variable must be involved to that particular equation. That's why we are called a linear equation. Then comes to another equation, quadratic. What is quadratic equation? The degree must be 2. We have learned in your previous classes, in class 10, x square plus 2x plus 3 equals to 0. Now it is only the variables are involved as well as the constants are involved with respect to their degree is involved. Now here LHS is there and RHS is there. So every equation must contain left hand side as well as right hand side. This is the quadratic equation of variables. In the same way, when the variables as well as the coefficients are involving to a particular equation, when it is called according to their degree is linear and according to degree is their quadratic. Here degree is 2. Here degree is 2. That's why it is called quadratic equation. When degree is 3, where degree is 3, then it becomes a cubic equation. For example, x cube plus x square plus 2x plus 1 equals to 0. Now, everywhere the variables are involving to that particular equation to represent the equation, whether it is a linear, whether it is a quadratic, and whether it is a cubic. If fourth power is there, then it is called a biquadratic equation. Okay. Then comes to our topic, differential equation. Must be here, variables are involving, that's why it is called a linear, quadratic, whatever it is. When one equation contains or involving derivatives, what is it? It is called differential equation. So derivative and differentiation is must there. So that's why when an equation involving derivative, then the equation is called as differential equation. The derivative involving to an equation is known as differential equation. So must derivative is must involving. What is derivative? Let us take a function that is y is equals to f of x. Everyone know any function you can take with respect to x. Differentiate y with respect to x. That is, d by dx of y, which is equals to d by dx of f of x. And d by dx of y is known as the derivative of y with respect to x. And it is dy by dx, which is equals to f dash x. We have learned in our previous classes. Now, can you say it is a differential equation? Because derivative is involving there. And with respect to one function is derivative. Okay, when dy by dx minus f dash x, which is equals to 0, it is a differential equation. So derivative is must involving that particular equation. So any equation involving derivative is known as differential equation. Now I will like to give some more examples of differential equation. Let me clear one thing. Write down this concept. Let y is equal to x square plus 3x plus 2. Again you start differentiate y with respect to x. So you start calculating its derivative, both the functions. Let it be f of x, it is given with involving the variable x, you know. Now dy by dx, which is equals to derivative with respect to x to the function x square plus 3x plus 2. Now dy by dx, which is equals to, now derivative of x square is 2x plus derivative of 3x is 3 and constant remains 0. Now dy by dx, when you transfer all the variables as well as constant from right to left, it will changes its sign, minus 2x minus 3, which is equals to 0. Now it will be converted a, now it is a differential equation. Why it is a differential equation? Now derivative must involve to that particular equation, that's why it is called a differential equation. Now comes to another concept, that is, what do you mean by independent and what do you mean by dependent? So we will clear the independent and dependent. Look at it. Let us take a Cartesian plane that is x axis and it is known as y axis. We will consider only the first quadrant. Let y is equal to f of x any function. You can take any function y is equal to f of x. Let you can take f of x is equals to x plus 3, that is y is equals to x plus 3. When you start putting the numericals over there, when x is equals to 1, y becomes 3, and you start plotting the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When you put x is equal to 1, y gives 3. So definitely, whatever the value of x, that will be the show the value of y. So y is always dependent on x. हम अगर वैल्यू यहाँ पे कोई भी एक्स का चेंज करते हैं तो वाई का भी वैल्यू चेंज होता है. तो किसका वैल्यू हम चेंज करते हैं ना, एक्स का अगर वैल्यू हम चेंज कर देंगे तो वाई इज ऑटोमेटिकली चेंज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द फंक्शन. ओके, व्हाट एवर द फंक्शन इज गिवन एनीवेयर. बट द प्रॉब्लम इज Why it is called x is independent? Because we are using any variables, any real numbers over there. So it is called independent axis. And whatever the points are used, independent points, we can use any point. And whatever the value of x, according to the value of x, y will changes. According to the value of x, y will changes. अगर हमने 1 put किया तो y 3 दिखा रहा है. देखो यहाँ पे अगर x 2 put कर दिया तो y कितना आ रहा है? 5 आ रहा है. अगर x में यहाँ पे 3 put कर दिया तो y क्या आ रहा है? 6 आ रहा है. तो everywhere the value of y changes. Why it changes? According to the value of x. So that's why y is totally depend on x. अगर x हम put करते हैं तो y ये दिखाएगा. That is main point. So y is called dependent axis. Y is called dependent axis. So this is independent axis and this is dependent axis. Whatever the function is, y is equals to f of x. Now comes to another topic. When you differentiate one differential equation, let y is given, whatever it is, x square plus 5x plus 3. Y is equals to f of x is given. It is confirmed. When you derivative dy by dx, that means you have to write, when you start converting this function to a particular differential equation, you start differentiate. The dependent variable, that is y, with respect to the dependent variable x. हम वैसे ही करते हैं ना, जब differentiate करते हैं, differentiate the function with respect to y, differentiate the function with respect to theta, differentiate the function with respect to many, where we are using in our last differentiation when studying. So always you difference, whenever you start finding a differential equation, you always differentiate the dependent variable with respect to independent variable. That means you start dy by dx, which is equals to 2x plus 5 and 3 becomes 0, and dy by dx minus 2x plus 5 equals to 0. So it is also a differential equation. So a differential equation always differentiate a dependent variable with respect to a independent variable. That is known as dy by dx. So clear the independent axis and about the dependent axis. Why time is called independent axis? Time never depends on any quantity, any physical quantity, whatever, any situation, whatever. Time does not depend on any person, nothing else. Time, देखते हो समय कभी रुकता है? एक बोलते हैं ना, समय नहीं कभी रुकता है. And always time, when you studied in your physics, time graph, time distance graph, whatever it is, time is always keep in independent axis, that is x axis. Time is always, हमेशा देखना x axis में हमारा time रहता है और यहाँ पे डिस्टेंस शो करता है. whatever it is. That's why time is called independent for any. So why we clear about the independent and dependent axis? Because whenever we differentiate any function, you should differentiate the dependent function with respect to the independent function. That is known as dy by dx. So whatever we have discussed here, now what will be the result? Look at here. What we have discussed here, linear equation we have discussed, quadratic equation discussed, cubic and biquadratic, whatever it is. What is the relationship between it with the differential equation? That is the only relationship, that the derivative involving that equation is known as differential equation. And variables as well as the constants involving to the equation is known as linear equation, quadratic equation, whatever may be. But it may depends on the degree. Now we will proceed further. Whenever we call the linear equation, quadratic equation, we must think about its degree. Same way, differential equation is there, we must think about its degree. But the question is, whenever we will start learning differential equation, we will must confirm about its order. What is order? Have you learned second order derivative? Yes. Third order derivative is there, fourth order derivative is there. Now we must clear about the notation part. Okay, how to represent the many differential equations having many order? But the question is, how we can notate? कैसे हम उसको लिखेंगे? So write a notation of differential equation. Notation of differential equation. Notation means हम उसको कैसे लिखेंगे? That is our concern. How to represent? Let us take one differential equation dy by dx. X dy by dx plus cy is equals to 0. Is it a differential equation? Any equation involving derivative is known as differential equation. Now tell me, what is the order of this differential equation? Kitne bar differentiate hua hai? Only ek bar. So we can write x is also y dash plus 3y is equals to 0. Ye dekho, ye ek notation hai. Hum usko y dash likh sakte hain, x y 1 likh sakte hain, plus 3y is equals to 0. So now let me clear one thing. Why I am writing y dash here or y prime, whatever you can say, and y 1 here? Because only one time we can differentiate. That's why you can use y prime only one time differentiation, and only one is also indicate the only one time differentiation. That is, I will like to share one example, make you clear. Y is equals to, take x cube plus 3x square, whatever it is given. Differentiate with respect to x, that is dy by dx, you start differentiating. This becomes 3x square plus 3 to the 6x. देखो ये मैंने एक बार डिफरेंशिएट किया, तो ओनली टाइम आई विल डिफरेंशिएट दिस फंक्शन. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन आल्सो राइट देयर y prime is equals to 3x square plus 6x. Both of our same meanings. This is only notation. We have to note it. Y dash means वहां पे derivative हुआ है. कितने बार हुआ है? Only one time. Then again derivative differentiate. Again differentiate. मैं फिर से इसको differentiate कर दूंगा. तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? d by d x of dy by dx which is equals to d by dx of 3x square plus 6x. We start second derivative and we know that is d square y by dx square which is equals to 3 to the 6x plus 6. Now come to second part. When first part derivative is over, we will notate that y1 or y dash. Also we can write y1 is equals to 3x square plus 6x. Then comes to here d square y by dx square which is equals to 6x plus 6 whatever may be. Now again derivative is there. A second time derivative, and it is always known second order derivative. You already learned in your previous chapter. Now it is written as d square y by dx square. We can write double prime. The same notation by second order है तो उसको दो prime दे दिया. First order है तो एक prime दे दिया. उसका meaning y, which is equals to 6x plus 6. And you can also write y2, 6x plus 6. Again comes to, again derivative, again differentiate. हम फिर से उसको differentiate किए. भाई कर दो differentiate. तो क्या हो जाएगा ये? D cube y by D x cube. इसको डेरिवेटिव कर दिया हमने 6 एंड अनदर 0. ये भी एक डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन बन सकता है. डी क्यू वाई बाय डी एक्स क्यू माइनस 6 इज इक्वल टू 0 इज ऑल्सो ए डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. पर हम उसको लिखेंगे कैसे पूरा इतना? भाई देखो डी वाई बाय डी एक्स बहुत लंबा हो जाता है तो हम उसको कॉमन नोटेशन कर रहे हैं. इसलिए वी विल डिस्कसिंग दैट नोटेशन ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन डी. तो नोटेशन क्या कर रहे हैं अभी देखो. इसको हम लिख देंगे क्या? y ट्रिपल प्राइम विच इक्वल्स टू 6. और क्या लिख सकते हैं? y 3 इज इक्वल्स टू 6 एंड सो ऑन. दैट मींस दीज थिंग्स आर रिप्रेजेंट दैट इज एंड दीज थिंग्स आर हेल्प यू डिटरमाइन द ऑर्डर ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. नाउ कम्स टू द ऑर्डर ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. Now write down. Order of differential equation. देखो, अभी तो हमने नोटेशन क्लियर हो गए. हम उसको रिप्रेजेंट कैसे करेंगे, लिखना कैसे है हमको, उसको ऑर्डर क्या करेंगे. देखो ना, फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डी वाई बाय डी एक्स प्लस साइन एक्स इज इक्वल टू 0. तो ये ऑर्डर क्या आएगा? 1. पहली बार डिफरेंशिएट हुआ है. मैं और एक एग्जांपल दे रहा हूँ, डी स्क्वायर वाई बाय डी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 3 डी वाई बाई डी एक्स प्लस 5 इक्वल्स टू 0. अभी यहाँ पे ऑर्डर कितना है? हाइस्ट ऑर्डर क्या है? 2. तो यहाँ पे ऑर्डर हम 2 लिख सकते हैं. हमेशा डेरिवेटिव का पावर देख लो, दैट विल इंडिकेट्स द ऑर्डर। यहाँ पे टू है जो हाईएस्ट है वही हमारा ऑर्डर कंसिडर होगा। देन कम्स टू टी क्यू वाई बाई डी एक्स क्यू प्लस थ्री डी वाई बाई डी एक्स प्लस फाइव कॉस टू जीरो। यहाँ पर ऑर्डर क्या है टेल मी, थ्री। अब ऑर्डर थ्री आ गया ना, नहीं। सो दैट विल इंडिकेट्स द ऑर्डर ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। Now I will like to give one question. देखो 3d5y by dx5 plus 2dqy by dx square प्लस टी वाई बाई डी एक्स इक्वल्स टू जीरो। तो यहां पे हाईएस्ट पावर क्या है फाइव, तो ऑर्डर क्या होगा डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन का फाइव बाई। कैन यू से द ऑर्डर इज थ्री, नो, द हाईएस्ट पावर, द हाईएस्ट पावर ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन is known as order, okay? जो पावर हाइस्ट रहेगा डेरिवेटिव इन्वॉल्विंग का उसको हम क्या करेंगे, कहेंगे ऑर्डर ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। सो स्टूडेंट्स टूडे वी हैव डिस्कस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, वॉट आर द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, वाई इट इज रिलेटेड टू लिनियर क्वाड्रेटिक वट एवर इट इज। So these things we are discussed. So you clear about the differential equation and how to find its order, the many things we have discussed. What is dependent axis, what is independent axis, why a function is differentiated to the dependent with respect to independent, everything we have discussed. In the next class we will discussing the degree of differential equation. Whenever you, I will start degree of differential equation, you must clear about the order. If your order of differential equation is clear and what is differential equation is clear, then it is very easy to determine the degree of differential equation. Thanks you, thank you, thanks a lot. This is my today's session.